Dear friends, this is R.V. Shekhar, practicing company secretary. In this video, today I am going to discuss, can a person who has attained the age of 70 can be appointed as an independent or non-executive director of a public company? So this is a very hot topic. There are a lot of confusion over it. So that's why I am giving a video on this. No age limit need be prescribed as per law. So as on date, there is no prescribed age has been prescribed by the Companies Act 2013. There should be an adequate disclosure of age in the company's documents given by the director. And also the company should disclose the age of the director. It should be the duty of the director to disclose his age correctly. So in case of public company, appointment of directors beyond a prescribed age, say 70 years, especially for managing director or old-time director or a manager, should be subject to a special resolution by the shareholders, which should also prescribe his term, how many years is going to occupy that position, for 5 years or like that. Continuation of a director above the age of 70 years beyond such term should be subject to a fresh resolution. In the as per section 196(3)(a), which lays down that no company shall appoint or continue the employment of any person as its managing director, old-time director or manager who is below the age of 20 years. So, a person cannot be appointed as a managing director or a old-time director or a manager or even an ordinary non-executive director below the age of 21 years or has attained the age of 70 years. So, if he is crossing the age of 70 years, he could not be appointed as a director. So, however, special resolution can be passed with the justification of such appointment shared stated in the notice as in the explanatory statement to the special resolution. So, most of the companies, for example, promoters may be, they cannot be just ignored because of their age. For example, Tata or Narayana Murthy, Ratan Tata, they have crossed 70 years. But they are the pillars. They are the pillars for the company. They cannot just ignore because of the age. That's why the Act has given this exception. 193(3)(a) says, no company shall appoint or continue the employment of a new person as managing director or old-time director. So, 196(3)(a) is clearly states that in case of appointment of managing director only, or old-time director or manager only, it should prescribe the age. It is below the age of 20 years or attain the age of 70 years, provided the appointment of a person who has attained the age of 70 years may be made by the passing a special resolution, in which case the explanatory statement annexed to the notice for such motion shall indicate the justification for appointing such person, provided further that where no such special resolution is passed, but votes cast in favor of motion exceeds the vote, that is just a simple majority, not special resolution, not a resolution passed with 75% of votes, just 50%, above 50%, but below 75%, if any, cast against the motion, and the central government is satisfied on an application made by the board that such appointment is most beneficial to the company, the appointment of the person who has attained the age of 70 years, they may be met with us. Then in such a case, in simple majority, not a special resolution, the board has to apply to central government. Central government has to give its approval. One another interesting situation happened in the following case. Honorable High Court of Mumbai had decided the following issues in case of Ultramarine and Pigments Limited by Mr. Rangasamy. As per provision, it is clear that if at the time of appointment of age of person is more than 70 years, then by passing a special resolution, that person can be appointed as a managing director or old-time director or manager. But now the question is, if person attains the age after the appointment during the tenure, then what are the consequences? For example, if the person has been appointed as a managing director at the age of 68, when he crosses at the age of 70, whether he will be able to continue the position as appointment as a director of the company or not? This question has been answered in this case. There is no mid-tenure cessation of managing director as a result of Section 193A. The court is has observed that. High Court observed that there is an age of 70. The age of 70 is an absolute bar. It has answered this question. A public limited company may well appoint a person of 80 years of age as a managing director. All that is needed is a special resolution. That is what the provision plainly says. Therefore, it is not an absolute bar, absolute restriction. According to the defendant, if a person who is of the age of 60 years is appointed after the year of the 1st April 2014 for 5 years, he shall not continue after the 2 years once he attains the age of 70 years. That was the argument posted by the defendant. The court did not agree to this view either and gave a judgment that the age is relevant only on the date of appointment, not any time later. While conducting the secretarial audit of the company, the practicing company secretary shall keep the judgment in view, the above judgment in view, while ascertaining the compliances with the provision of section 196 of the Companies Act 2013 by the company. So whenever the secretarial auditor should make his secretarial audit, during the course of his secretarial audit, he should ask the company what are the age of the directors and verify that, so that he can report in his that none of the directors crossed the age of 70, and in such a cases special resolution has been passed by the company or not. SEBI amended the clause relating to board of directors in the listing regulations and inserted the regulation 17-1A of the. So as per listing agreement, what we have to do? No listed entity shall appoint a person or continue the directorship of any person as a non-executive director who has attained the age of 75 years. So SEBI listing agreement says if once the director has crossed 75 years, unless a special, so in this case, a special resolution has been only in case he has 75 years. So there is a contradiction between the Companies Act and SEBI LODR. So unless a special resolution passed to that effect, in which case the explanatory statement annexed to the notice for such motion shall indicate the justification for appointing such a person. In SEBI case, it states only in the case of 75 years. So in the Companies Act says only 70 years. So there is a contradiction. So we have to take, when the listed company, it's better to pass a special resolution and the age of, when the director crosses the age of 70 years, so that it will cover at the age of 75 years, or also when they are going to extend his appointment. So I am going to conclude in my conclusion in this: independent director or non-executive director, the main question is, can be appointed in a public company even if he attained the age of 70 years as per section 193(6). So the one section, the section 196(3)(a) says what only in the case of appointment of managing director, full-time director or manager of a public company, approved by special resolution is needed. So it is silent about the appointment of independent director or non-executive director or a manager. So in such a case, there is no bar for appointing a person who has crossed the age of 70 as an independent executive director in public company. But it is better to have a special resolution passed at the age of 70, giving various explanation in the explanatory statement. The age is, according to the Ultramarine case, Ultramarine Pigments Limited versus Rangasami Sambar, the age is relevant only at the date of appointment and not any time later as held in Ultramarine. And even listed companies can appoint an independent director, non-executive director, who has attained the age of 70 or above, but only by passing a special resolution, as the listed companies have to take the approval from them. Anyhow, the listed companies have to take the approval from the members for appointment of independent in the general meeting. So it is better to pass a special resolution in the general meeting in case we want to appoint an independent director and a non-executive director who has crossed 70 years. If not, wait for, as per SEBI LODR, it is 75. So it is better to take at the age of 70 years, so that the company fulfills the criteria under the Companies Act 2013, and there is no bar for a private limited company to appoint a person as a director who has attained the age of 70. He may be a private company can appoint a managing director or a director in the company who has attained the age of 70 years. There is no need for passing a special resolution for a private limited. Friends, thank you for watching this video, and if you have any doubt, please put your comment on your box, comment box, and also I request you to share, like, and subscribe my channel so that whenever I issue a new video on a new topic, it will reach you directly. Thanking you once again. This is RV Shekhar, practicing company secretary.